Awesome. Jonathan Romlikon, Five Reasons Sports. Hey, Josh, this is your first fight here in the PFL regular season. Just your thoughts on the PFL as a whole, as well as the regular season format and the $1 million prize.
I think it's cool. I think it's something new. It's something that I feel like I could build with, and we could grow together, you know, with the new organization and stuff.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you're currently sitting undefeated 8-0 as a pro. What do you feel like you've been doing right to stay undefeated? And what do you feel like you need to continue to do entering the PFL as a fighter?
I got to give a lot to my team. You know, they keep me in check, from my father, my coach, down the line to all the guys in the background work, man. They all support each other, and we try to just build our career patiently. And then when we got to take the chance, you know, we'll make that jump. So I think that's been a big help for my career. And yeah, man, I think I don't really got to change anything, just more maybe add some stuff and tweak some things here and there. But I think what we're doing is perfectly, perfectly good.
Yeah, man. And last one for me, you had a fight in the Challenger Series, which earned you a contract to be in this position. How will chasing a finish for the contract transfer over to chasing a finish for points to make the playoffs this year?
That's just the way I fight in general. You know, I'm always looking for the finish. So I don't think anything changes from the Contender Series to this fight. Hopefully the guy doesn't grab the cage and fish hook me. But other than that, and it's the same mission every time, you know, try to get the finish, don't force it, but just let the fight develop and it'll come, you know.
Awesome, man. I appreciate you. Good luck this Friday, and hopefully no fish hooking or fence grabbing.
Yeah. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Salvador.
Hey, Josh. Sal Garcia with Punchy Media. So obviously, you know, you're undefeated. You were just the second LFA double champion in the organization's history. Do you play into breaking records and trying to build up accolades, or is it all just part of the journey?
We like to say that the decisions were chose a long time ago. You know, we made these decisions a long time ago, and of course things change here and there, but yeah, man, who doesn't like, you know, doing new things and being double champ and breaking accolades and stuff like that. You know, that's what it's all about, pushing the limits. So I'm all for that stuff.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Jim Barcelone.
Hey, thank you, Josh. I'm first just what's curious. Up? Hey, I'm curious what's with up? The bearded warrior, man. Speaking of fishing, you got that bearded look now. What's going on there?
You know, times change, man. You know, my dad's barbarian, right? So we gotta keep the beards in check. Last time I shaved the beard, I almost got my first loss on my record. So I got to keep the beard and keep the barbarian look. It runs in my blood.
Hey, I'm very curious. What happened for you with the Sortie fight? And physically, how do you feel now coming in with the Hamlet fight?
Man, so for the Sortie fight, I prepared for it really good. Same thing with this fight. I just had a little tweak in my shoulder, my AC joint. I fell on my shoulder. Not bad enough to count me out, you know, it was just unfortunate. It was a week out of the fight. So I physically probably couldn't have done anything, but took me about 3 weeks to get back on the horse, and here we are, and I'm so excited to be here, man. I've been itching to fight. I almost did like two camps in one, you could say, you know. So I'm itching.
And then lastly for me, Shoeface, I'm just curious if you did any training with him for this one, because he had fought Hamlet in the PFL season last season, and I don't even know if you take anything away from that because that fight, because it was so long ago, but what are your thoughts of that?
Yeah, you know, me and Shoeface worked a lot previously before he was in PFL. We've always worked together, but for this particular fight, he worried more about his opponent. You know, his opponent is not so much of a grappler. So fortunately at American Top 10, we have so many training partners that we could go pick, we could make our little group and train and stuff. And if we need to train together, we will. But no, we didn't do much training this time because it's just, you know, he'd rather go fight somebody that's more Brucey Soto's style versus a grappler like myself or anything like that.
All the best, Josh. Thank you as always.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate it.
Benjamin.
Hey, Josh. Now, with this PFL regular season debut, are there any tangible differences between the Challenger Series and the regular season in your mind, or is it all just the same fights or fights?
Yeah, man, fights are fights. I think to add on to that, like I said, I've helped guys in the previous PFL seasons. So I would always go to the fights to cheer them on, especially when I was at the Hard Rock. So I was always there looking at the format, you know, kind of having that future mindset of, man, this might be the show that I fight for, you know. I always knew it was, you know, PFL or UFC or whatever the case could be, you know. So it was cool to actually be a part of it and be there, watch the fight. So for me, it's all the same. You know, the Challenger Series is just something, I think, to build up the guys, and it's great. I think it's awesome, but a fight's a fight, right? Get in the cage, get locked up.
Last one for me. Can you detail how important the bond with your father, Conan, has been to your MMA career overall?
Yeah, man. I think everybody could see that. That's a great bond. It's a great team we have. And, you know, you see a lot of father and son relationships. Sometimes they're not as great, but my dad is good, man. He's amazing. I'm not the first fighter he's dealt with, you know? So I think he's still learning. We're learning together, but this is definitely a new experience for both of us. And it's amazing, you know, win or lose. It's the journey is awesome. I love doing it with him, and I could see us going, you know, only the future could tell what's going to happen, but we're going to be side by side always and forever. Probably most likely we are, you know?
All right. Daniel.
Josh, welcome to Atlanta.
Thank you, brother.
How you liking it here so far?
It's good. It's not that much different than Florida, you know? So we got the hot sun and the humidity, but it's cool with me. Better than the dry heat in Arizona.
Listen, you're taking on a guy in Marthin Hamlet. He's super strong, super physical. Even in fights that he's lost, he's had a lot of success. How do you think you guys match up?
I think we match up pretty well on paper too. You know, he's 9-3. I'm 8-0. On paper, it's a good fight. I think the wrestling, you know, cancels out. He's a Greco guy. I'm more of a folk style wrestler. You know, I attack the legs. I attack everywhere. He's a Greco guy. I love Greco. I did a lot of it in college. I was a big thrower. It's going to be a good fight. I just think that I've been, you know, my record doesn't show my experience, man. I just been around it for so long. Just watching the sport MMA grow. I just been around it so long. And I think that's going to be the difference in this fight, where when it's more than just the technique, it's the mindset, you know, just going over there, maybe weathering the storm a little bit. He is a strong guy. And then eventually just taking him to the deep waters, where I always like to do, you know, and find the right moment, finish the fight.
Thanks, Josh. Best of luck, man.
Thank you, sir.
Dave. You're on mute, Dave.
Hey, what's up, Josh? How you doing, brother?
What's up, brother?
Man, in Arlington a couple weeks ago, PFL 3, the Challenger Series had a really good night. Even with Carlos Liao defeating, you know, the last year's champion, Ray Cooper. Did that give you a little extra juice? Or like, hey, these Challenger Series, you're part of that crew, that team. Did that give you a little bit of juice going into this weekend's fight?
Yeah, man, I wouldn't say necessarily some juice, but I never count the underdogs out, man. You know, PFL is a growing show. They're going to bring fighters. It's only going to get tougher. So I was a little surprised because, you know, Ray Cooper is tough. But, man, that Brazilian, he's tough as nails, and he deserved that win right there, you know. And definitely, you know, that's a point for the Challenger Series, you know, if you want to put in that aspect. But, of course, that's cool to see other guys go there and win, you know. Of course, I want to be one of them guys too. I will be one of them guys.
For sure, man. Appreciate it. I know Jeremy Stevens is doing the whole hair thing, but I think you got this weekend on lock. I think you got the best hair of the crew, you know?
Yeah, I got a question for you. Shit, I was thinking about braiding them, but should I just let it flow? The flow's pretty nice right now.
Let those things flow, my man. You know what I'm saying? Right, let those things loose.
Let's go. We're going to let it
all
loose.
All right, my man. Nice. Good luck.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate it.
All right, guys. Any last questions for Josh before we let him go? Jim Barcelone says no braids, by the way.
No braids.
Right.
Thanks, Jim.